Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Mandeep from GNDU Amritsar. Today we are going to talk on the module of social responsibility of business from the paper Business Environment. After the completion of this module, I am sure that you will be able to understand the concept of social responsibility of business or corporate social responsibility. You will be able to understand the different stakeholders of the business and also the provisions of social responsibility given under the various acts, especially Companies Act 2013. Now, what is the social responsibility? Social responsibility refers to the obligations or the duties of the business towards the society where they are living. As per K.K. Andrew, social responsibility may be taken to mean intelligent and social objective concern for the welfare of the society. H.S. Singhania classifies the nature of social responsibility into two categories. That is, the manner in which the business carries on its business activity and the welfare activity that it takes upon itself as additional function. While there is no universal definition of corporate social responsibility, it generally refers to transparent business practices that are based on the ethical values, compliance with the legal requirements, and respect for the people, community, and the environment where they are working. Thus, beyond making profits, companies are also responsible for the totality of their impact on people and the planet. People here constitute the company's stakeholders, maybe the employees, maybe the customers, maybe the business partners, maybe the suppliers or the investors, vendors, government as well as the community. Increasingly, these stakeholders expect that the companies should be more environmentally and socially responsible in conducting their business. In the business community, the CSR, that is corporate social responsibility, is alternatively referred to as the corporate citizenship, which essentially means that a company should be a good neighbor with its host community. So why do organizations decide to get involved in social responsibility? There are many reasons. Due to the growing competition in today's time, more and more companies are realizing that in order to remain productive, competitive, and relevant, they have to be socially responsible. Moreover, globalization has blurred national borders, and the technology has accelerated time and masked distance. Because of the globalization, there's also fierce competition for skilled employers, investors, and consumer loyalty. Thus, CSR, that is corporate social responsibility, has become a determinant of the sustainability and success of an organization. Now, when we say that the companies have their social responsibility towards the various stakeholders, company itself, the organization itself, benefits from this. How? Satisfied stakeholders, whether they're employees of your company, whether they are distributors of your company, whether they are investors or shareholders, and the society at large, when they will be satisfied, your organization will benefit. Positive public relations, it's another benefit that the organizations get. Improved public image of the business, because whenever every stakeholder is satisfied, it will build goodwill of the company. Positive word of mouth, which is basically a very good advertisement source. Cost reduction through efficient staff hire and retention, implementation of energy saving programs, effective management of potential risks and liabilities more effectively, less investment in the traditional advertising, because they don't have to go for advertising when their goodwill is better and there is positive word of mouth. Moreover, more business opportunities can be there as an outward approach.
Now, what are the factors that affect the orientation of a business towards social responsibility? The first one of them is board of directors. Board of directors decide the major policies and resource allocation of the company. Then promoters and top management. The value and vision of the promoters and top management is also another factor. Stakeholders and internal power relations. Social responsibility involves attempting to unite the diverse interests of the stakeholders to form a workable coalition engaged in creation of value for distribution among the members of the coalition. Then societal factors. The societal orientation is affected by the nature, compulsions and expectation of the society. Government and law. The business has to fulfill the social responsibilities by virtue of them being codified in law. Competitors. If the competitors do not fulfill their social responsibility, a business may gain competitive advantage over the competitors by engaging in social activities. Resources. Social involvement of a business is affected and often constrained by the financial and other sources. Now, we were talking about stakeholders. What are the different stakeholders of a business? Stakeholders of the company are defined as those groups without whose support the organization would cease to exist, as given in Stanford Research Institution. A corporate stakeholder is a person or party that can affect or be affected by the actions of a business as a whole. Now, there are different stakeholders of the business. Stakeholders can be primary or internal, they can be secondary or external. The stakeholders are the ones who directly affect a business organization and are also directly affected by it. For example, the stockholders, that is the shareholders, employees, owners, managers, board of directors, etc. They are known as primary stakeholders. Then come secondary stakeholders. These stakeholders, although don't engage in direct economic exchange with an organization, they, however, can affect or be affected by its action. For example, customers, suppliers, creditors, employees, general public, communities, activist groups, business support groups, and media, etc. What is the basic difference between internal and external stakeholders of the business on the basis of certain characteristics? As far as the meaning is concerned, the individual and parties that are part of organization are known as internal stakeholders, and the parties, the groups that are not a part of the organization but get affected by its activities are known as external stakeholders. Now, if you talk about the nature of impact, internal stakeholders have the direct impact while the external stakeholders are having indirect impact. Who are these stakeholders? The internal stakeholders serve the organization while the external stakeholders get influenced by the organization's work. Internal stakeholders are employed by the business organization while external stakeholders are never employed. Responsibility of the company towards them, that is the internal stakeholders, is primary in nature while for the external stakeholders it is secondary in nature. Internal stakeholders include employees, owners, board of directors, managers, investors, etc. And external stakeholders include suppliers, customers, creditors, clients, intermediaries, competitors, society, and government, etc. Let's discuss about the concerns of different stakeholders. Now, if you talk about the government concern is regarding taxation, VAT, legislation, employment, truthful reporting of the things, legalities, externalities. As far as employees are concerned, they are concerned with the rate of pay, that is the salary or wages they are getting, the security, the compensation, respect, truthful communication. Consumers are concerned with the value, quality, customer care, that is after service, we can say, then ethical products. Now, the suppliers are directly concerned, being the providers of the products and services, they are concerned with the customers' equitable business opportunities. Creditors, as the stakeholders, are concerned with credit score, new contacts, and liquidity of the company. community is concerned with jobs, involvement, environmental protection, shares, truthful communication. Trade unions have the concern regarding the quality and the worker protection, that means the job, etc. Honor of the company or honor of any organization is concerned with its profitability, longevity, market share, market standing, succession planning, raising of the capital, growth and social goals, and of course market share. Investors, being an important stakeholder, are concerned with income, that is the return on investment. Now we are talking about stakeholders. Let's discuss about the responsibilities towards different stakeholders of the business. Now shareholders, being one of the important stakeholders, the responsibility toward them is great. In order to protect the interest of the shareholders, the primary business of the business is to stay in business. Its a business should therefore fulfill its economic objective. Protect the interests of the shareholders, it should safeguard the capital, earn responsible dividend, and maintain a successful competitive position. Having said this, the business should realize that the shareholders are interested not only in the wealth creation but also in the societal performance of the company. It shall therefore be the advisor of the company to make and improve its public image. Next comes the employees as the stakeholders, and the companies or the organization have great responsibility towards them. It includes the payment of decent wages, decent working conditions, fair work standards, provision of labor welfare facilities, arrangement of proper training and development, reasonable chances and fair method of promotions, proper recognition, appreciation and encouragement, installation of efficient grievance handling mechanism and opportunity to participate in management decision making. Responsibilities of the organization towards consumers. Nowadays, in the competitive world, consumer is considered as a king. So, any organization has great responsibilities towards them, like to engage and spend adequately on R&D, that is research and development, in order to improve the quality of the products and services, to supply products and services at decent prices, to provide after-sale services, to ensure that an appropriate customer grievance management system is in place in case of dispute, etc. To provide necessary information for the usage of the products and services, and to not engage in misleading advertisements. Moreover, to understand the customer needs and respond adequately to them. Business has responsibilities towards community also, like prevention of the environmental pollution, rehabilitation of population distributed by the business, assisting the overall development of the society, improving the efficiency of the business operation, contributing to research and development, development of economically backward areas, promoting the small scale industries and even the indigenous industries, and contributing towards social causes like promotion of education and population control, etc. The business is having a responsibility towards different stakeholders, and one of them is environment, which is very important. For discharging responsibility towards environment, first is a preventive role, meaning thereby that the business should take all possible steps to ensure that no further damage is done to the environment. For this, business must follow the rules and regulations laid down by the government to control pollution at the very inception. Second is a curative role, meaning thereby that the business should rectify whatever damage has been done to the environment. For example, by planting of trees, substantially reducing air pollution near the industrial area. Third important role is awareness role, making people, whether they are employees or the general public, aware about the causes and consequences of environmental pollution so that they voluntarily try to protect rather than to damage the environment. How to measure and evaluate an organization's social performance? An organization's social performance is an aggregate of its economic, legal, ethical, and discretionary responsibilities. Carroll defines corporate social responsibility as an entire range of obligations to the society, has proposed a multidimensional conceptual model of corporate performance. According to him, a firm has four categories of obligations of corporate performance. These are economic responsibilities, legal responsibilities, ethical responsibilities, and discretionary responsibilities. As far as economic responsibilities are concerned, it has been argued that a company should be operated on a profit-oriented basis with its sole mission to increase the profits as long as it stays within the rule of the game. As far as legal responsibilities are concerned, that is what is considered as important with respect to proper corporate behavior. This means to ensure compliance and adherence to the laid down rules, laws, and regulations that a business unit is deemed to follow. Ethical responsibilities include the behavior that is not necessarily codified into law and may not serve the organization's direct economic interests. To be ethical, organization decision makers should act with equity, fairness, and impartiality. Last one is discretionary responsibilities, which is purely voluntary and guided by an organization's desire to make social contributions and not mandated by economic laws or ethics. Now that measuring and evaluating of organization social performance has been shown in this diagram, which is basically a summarized view of the Carroll's model of business responsibilities. As far as social responsibility is concerned, there are certain arguments for and there are certain arguments against. Let's first of all talk about arguments for social responsibility. Business survives using the resources of the society. It therefore owes a responsibility towards it in return. Since business is an integral part of the socio-economic system, it should therefore be responsible towards it. Moreover, social responsibility improves the image of the organization. Social involvement fosters a harmonious and healthy relationship between the society and the business, which is giving the mutual benefit to both. Social responsibility also has an implication for reduction in unnecessary government regulation and interventions. It also helps in spreading positive word of mouth. It keeps the stakeholders happy and satisfied and also improves the corporate reputation. Moreover, social responsibility helps an organization in gaining a competitive edge.
Like every aspect, there are certain things which are positive and certain which are negative. So is the social responsibility. Many arguments are given against the social responsibility. That is, the business should confine itself to the business operations. So social organization should carry out the social works. This is the saying of some of the people. The ultimate cost of social responsibility is to be borne by the consumer in terms of heavy pricing. So whatever they are doing for society, they are going to get out of the add in the price, so it will be taken from the consumer. Involvement in the social activities may adversely affect the economic health of the organization. Companies engage in the social activities for seeking tax exemptions rather than focusing for the societal welfare. It is said that the social involvement causes an increase in the price of the company's product or service, and severely it affects the competitiveness of the company. Moreover, social involvement of the business can unnecessarily lead to an increase in the dominance or influence of the business over the society.
What limits organizations from being socially responsible? First one is cost. Every social action requires money for its fulfillment. For example, donations given to various rural areas, hospital, educational institutions, expenditure for organizing any campaign, adoption of the village, etc. At time, a business may want to engage in such activities, but due to the paucity of funds, it becomes a major impediment in this regard. The second one is efficiency. An effort towards social responsibility may bring down the efficiency and competitiveness of the business. Social activities are not the core business activities. Hence, a business may not have an adequate idea about this and thus indulge in overspending. Also, this may act as a distraction for the employees, which may result in loss of business efficiency. Third factor is relevance. Some critics are of the view that a business has no obligation towards a society. According to Friedman, there is only one social responsibility of the business, and that is to use its resources appropriately to increase the profits so that it stays within the rules of the game and engages in open and free competition without deception and fraud. Another factor is scope. A business has a number of complex problems which are to be solved and concentrated upon. It is thus unfair to expect from a business to solve other complex problems that are beyond its operational ambit. Barriers to social responsibility. There are managers, organization itself, industry, and the division. As far as managers are concerned, low support and commitment from the managers, typically in the absence of a formal social policy, becomes a barrier. Societal committees may hamper the attainment of the economic objectives of the business. Indulgence in social activities by one company may cause distrust of others operating in the same industry. It thus becomes difficult for the company to survive in the industry. Any social responsibility decision which may affect or reduce the profit might threaten the existence of a particular division.
Now let's talk about overview of certain rules of social responsibility under the Companies Act 2013. The new Companies Act 2013 has introduced several new provisions for the corporate social responsibility of the Indian companies. These provisions have been notified by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs under Section 135 and Schedule 7th of the Companies Act. These provisions are regarding the CSR spending of the companies. Section 135 of the Companies Act provides the threshold limit for applicability of CSR to the company, that is, the net worth of the company to be rupees 500 crore or more, turnover of the company to be rupees 1000 crore or more, net profit of the company to be rupees 5 crore or more. Further, as per the CSR rules, the provisions of CSR are not only applicable to Indian companies, but also applicable to the branches and the project offices of the foreign company in India. CSR committee and policy. According to this, every qualifying company requires spending of at least 2% of its average net profit for the immediately preceding three financial years on CSR activities. Further, the qualifying company will be required to constitute a committee, that is CSR committee, of the board of directors consisting of three or more directors. This CSR committee shall formulate and recommend to the board a policy which shall indicate the activities to be undertaken as a policy of the CSR and also recommend the amount of expenditure to be incurred on these activities which have been referred and monitor the CSR policy of the company. The board shall take into account the recommendations made by this committee and approve the CSR policy of the company. Overview of the rules for social responsibility as given in Companies Act 2013. According to that act, the term CSR has been defined under the CSR rules, which includes but is not limited to projects or programs relating to activities specified in the schedule or projects or programs relating to activities undertaken by the board in pursuance of recommendations of the CSR committee as per the declared CSR policy, subject to the condition that such policy covers subjects enumerated in the schedule. Activities under CSR according to Companies Act 2013.
the activities that can be done by the company in order to achieve its ESR obligation include eradicating extreme hunger and poverty, promotion of education, promoting gender equality and empowering women, reducing child mortality and improving maternal health, combating human immunodeficiency virus acquired, immune deficiency syndrome, malaria and other diseases, ensuring environmental sustainability, employment enhancing vocational skills, social business projects, other funds set up by the central government or the state government for the socio-economic development and the relief, and the funds for the welfare of the scheduled castes, the scheduled tribes and other backward classes, minorities and women, and such other matters as may be prescribed. Under the Companies Act 2013, preference should be given to local areas and the areas where the company operates. Company may also choose to associate with two or more companies for fulfilling their CSR activities, provided they are able to report individually. The CSR committee shall also prepare the CSR policy, in which it includes the projects and programs which is to be undertaken, prepare a list of projects and programs which a company plans to undertake during the implementation year, and also to focus on integrating business models with social and environmental priorities and process in order to create share value. Now let's discuss about CSR activities of some of the companies operating in India. Tata Group established major institutions like Indian Institute of Science, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Tata Agricultural and Rural Training Center for Blind in Gujarat. Next, Birlas. They established Birla Institute of Technology in Pilani and Ranchi, Birla Institute of Scientific Research and Birla Economic Research Foundation. Company Larsen & Toubro, L&T Institute of Technology in Mumbai. Thapar Group established Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology in Patiala and Football Academy in Punjab. Modi's Shri Modi Eye Hospital and Ophthalmic Research Center, M.M. Modi Degree College, Sainik Bhavan and Sanskrit Pathshala. Hero Honda established Bahadur Chand Munirial Arya Model Senior Secondary School. APJ Surendra Company established APJ Chain of Schools. Bajaj, Institute of Gandhian Studies, Shiksha Mandal, Gandhi Gyan Mandir, Gitae Mandir, Gita Pratisthan. Shriram, that is DCM Group, Shriram College of Commerce, New Delhi, and Lady Shriram College of Commerce, again in New Delhi.
So let's now summarize what we have learned in this module. Social responsibility of the business, or corporate social responsibility, is an ethical framework that suggests that an entity or an organization has the responsibility to act for the benefit of society at large, the society where they are living. Social responsibility is therefore a duty that an organization should perform so as to maintain a balance between the economy and the ecosystem. A trade-off may exist between the economic responsibilities of the company and the welfare of the society or social responsibilities of the company. Social responsibility means sustaining the equilibrium between these two. This responsibility can be passive by avoiding engaging in socially harmful acts, or active by performing activities that directly advance social goals. Thus, social responsibility is a voluntary effort on the part of the business to take various steps to satisfy the expectations of the different interest groups while achieving and fulfilling its economic and legal responsibilities. Thank you.